Good morning, everybody. This is Eric from Coffee, Beers, and Bowties. I wanted to just jump on and brew a little bit of morning coffee with you guys. So it's been a couple of days since I posted the last brewing session. So I'm back here again to for us to brew up some more coffee. Nothing spectacular about today, except for the fact that I am gonna brew one of the Hawaiian coffees that I got from from my daughter who was on vacation there. And traditionally, well, I think it's, you know, it's fitting or befitting that while we brew this great Hawaiian coffee that we listen to some music from Hawaii. So right now we have playing Irie Love, who's R&B and reggae artist from Hawaii. So we're listening to some of her music and we're gonna brew up some Kona coffee. And hopefully this is take you straight to the islands. And so this is what we've got going on today. Some Kona coffee, we're gonna brew this today. We're gonna brew up some Kona coffee. So again, this is a split video. So I have a camera over there and I have a camera up there. So we're gonna try to make this thing work to the best that we can. So what we're doing today, of course, we're gonna do this medium roast Kona coffee today, and we're gonna brew it via the Chemex. All right, so I already have the gooseneck kettle already warm to temperature, the 205 for the brew that we're gonna do today, and we're gonna go with the Chemex already been rinsed out and ready to go. So here's the Chemex. Today we're gonna go with the brown filter. So that's what we're gonna do. So we're gonna go ahead and get this thing open. I already know it's gonna smell great. So as you can see, it's a brand new bag. Haven't opened it up yet, but we're gonna crack it open now and get a nice smell of what they've got going on over in the islands. So as of today, I think I've been to Hawaii maybe 7 or 8 times. Most of that was, you know, when I was in the military coming back from deployment, and you know, it was stopped in Hawaii. But on vacation, it's one of my favorite places to go as well. So with our family, I think we've been there, family vacations, maybe 3 times, but over just time, I think I've been to Hawaii maybe a total of maybe an additional 4 or 5 times. So I've been there about 7, 8 times in total. And I can tell you what, I've never not had a good time. So, so I'm glad to be here to be roasting some coffee from Hawaii. So right off the bat, the smell of this coffee is incredible. So we're gonna get started. We're gonna just get started and we're just gonna brew this on up. So let's go ahead and get our scale going, and I'm gonna measure out. I wanna have enough to drink a couple of cups today. So I think with this medium roast and just based off of the smell and the aroma of it, I think I'm gonna go with about 32, maybe right at 33 grams for me. That'll make a decent pot for, you know, for me. So all right, we're gonna seal that up. All right, and so as you guys can see from this camera, hopefully it gets down there. Let me take a peek back here, and if not, then I'll help it out a little bit. So we got about 33 grams right there on the scale. So all right, let's go ahead and first things first. All right, so let's go ahead and we're gonna rinse the filter and we're gonna temper the glass in the Chemex. All right, try not to make this too long for you guys. All right, So with the Chemex filter, you want to take the filter, it's folded in like fours, and so you want to take the three part and put it toward the spout as per Chemex themselves. All right, so we're going to do that, and now we're going to go ahead and we're going to rinse to get some of that paper taste, smell out of it. And then of course, like I said, you want to be able to temper the glass. Okay, so we got that thing in there. Of course, we're gonna whirl that around a little bit for you up here. So, and this warms the Chemex so that when you get ready to start your brewing process, you don't lose you don't lose that much temperature as you're brewing. So this warms up the glass and gets you going. All right, so that's good enough for me. I'm gonna go ahead and sink, and we're gonna dump this water out. Okay, so we're back with that. Okay, so now we're gonna take our beans, and we're gonna do the electric grinder. All right, so this is gonna get a little loud here, guys, so I'm gonna try to cut this out for you, but here we go. All right, so with my coffee beans, what I typically like to do when I do the grinder, depending on which coffee bean it is. This is my first time using the Kona coffee, so I'm not really sure what consistency, but right now, just as a default for the way I like my coffee, I'm gonna grind this to like a medium or a fine medium, not too coarse, but I think this ought to give me the brew that the blend that I want. So I'm gonna take this and go ahead and put it into the Chemex, into the filter. All right, as you guys can kind of see from this one, that's kind of the consistency I like to have my coffee ground. So we're just gonna take that and put that into the filter. I have my little brush right here to get everything out. Okay, so we've got that coffee all out of there. Put the lid back on and sit this over here. And so I'm gonna take this, just kind of give it a good shake so it can settle. And again, like I said, I have my trick from Wise Amaya. You take the scoop and make a little indentation into the mound of coffee there. And now we're ready to introduce the water to the coffee grind. All right, and so I'm gonna turn this and get that filter out of your way so you guys can see that. So we're just gonna pour this in and just barely cover it to allow it to bloom. And hopefully you guys can see inside of that filter of what it looks like once it starts to bloom. It starts to bubble, and that allows it to saturate and let some of the gases, to let the gases out, to give you a better tasting coffee. Okay, so we're gonna let that do its thing for about 30 seconds, and then we're gonna continue with the rest of the brew. Okay, this is some good music here. Ari Love from Hawaii, check her out. Okay. All right, here we go. So we're gonna go ahead and start introducing the rest of the water to get the brew going. All All right, and again, I have my water in the gooseneck kettle already pre-measured. So I'll take this and I'll just continue to brew until I use all of my water, and that should give me a perfect, should make for a perfect cup of coffee. Circular motion. We'll let that brew and do its thing. I really like using the Chemex. I love brewing coffee in general. Whatever way I can do it, I love brewing it. I think in the sometimes in the afternoon, I like to go and use the AeroPress because it's quicker. But I love using all these different brewing methods with coffee. So with this particular Kona coffee, I'm doing the Chemex first, and then tomorrow I'll probably use the AeroPress, and then maybe the V60, and see which one gives me the absolute best taste of coffee, best cup of coffee. Okay. Put a little bit more water in there. Let that brew. Come on, you. All right, so what do you guys have planned for the rest of the week? For myself, I've got some assignments to do. I'm taking some digital media courses, and I'll be knocking out some of that homework this week. And you know, you're never too old to learn. So, you know, if there's something that you have ambitious about, if something that you know, whether it's a photography class, or whether it's a videography class, or whether it's choreography, or whether it's yoga, or whether it's, you know, anything that you have an interest in and you haven't quite had the opportunity to explore those things, do it. Go out there. You'll never know. So that's my advice to any and everyone. You're never too old or too young to learn. And so if there's something that you're intrigued by, something that you're interested in, and you just haven't quite put your hands on it just yet, go out there and do it. Go out there and explore. There's a lot of things in the world. And I just say, you know, I've had a fortunate opportunity to be able to see a lot of things at an early age. And right now I'm just really tapping into that potential, those things that I've always thought about doing and never got a chance to do just yet. And so, and that's what I hope to do, to grow in the coffee, you know, in the coffee industry, learn more about the coffee industry, learn more about the hair and grooming industry, and learn more about the fashion industry, hence the coffee beards and bow ties. Coffee industry, beards is hair and grooming industry, and bow ties is the fashion industry. So those are the things that I'm interested in. Those are my passions. And so the more I drink coffee, the more I buy it from different regions, the more I learn about it, the better equipped I am to create or help you guys help me create this community of oneness inside of those industries. And so that's why I'm doing all this, is to be able to connect to you all and just to learn more, to better myself. And hopefully there's some things and experiences that I've had over the years that I can bring to you and, you know, help you learn from me as well. So, all right. So we're about brewed down with our coffee. All right. So that's about brewed down. And so you got to be careful in this part, because even though the coffee is pretty much dripped and brewed down, the filter and the coffee grounds inside of the filter is still pretty hot. Alexa, repeat those songs, please.
I'll repeat the song.
There you go. I'll take that. All right, and so now we're gonna just take the filter. I like to just fold it over like this to keep any of the coffee grind from falling in. And then I give it a little squeeze, try to get that last couple of drips out. All right, and get my paper towel right here, grab that. And so here is the moment of truth. And so like I told you guys from my other video, I like to kind of pre-treat my coffee mug. So I already have my creamer in there. And so the creamer I use is a little bit of the Cold Stone sweet cream creamer. That's what I use. Trying to watch some calories, but hey, you know, I like what I like. And so I have that already in there. And so, and here we go. What our pour. So I know I'm up here, but it's gonna be pouring down here. All right, so here we go. What our pour. All right. And that's that right there. We've got our cup of coffee. That's how I like it. It smells incredible. It smells incredible. All right. I know I say that about all these coffees. There are some that I've had, maybe not so much, but this one smells incredible. So let's see. Oh, man. Oh man. Found another one, guys. All right, so found another one. Kona coffee, medium roast. This is some good stuff right here. So, all right, I'm gonna put this video together and get it out there to you guys. If you're on vacation, and you're in the islands, or you decide to order some online, if you see some inside a supermarket somewhere in your local, wherever you're from, pick up a bag, give it a try, leave some comments. www.coffeebeersandbowties.com. Let me know what you guys think. Kona coffee, I'm going to post it on the website. It's going to be on the Instagram. And thank you guys for watching.